Hello, royal folks. It's good to see you all here again. This is your regular dose of royal news and analysis. Before we move on to any further details, I would really love to thank you all for your enormous love and support. In case you haven't subscribed yet, I mean, what are you waiting for, guys? Hit that subscribe button now. Also, please don't forget to press the bell icon. And also, if you enjoy the content and want to be a part of our inner circle, consider supporting us on Patreon. It's where we share exclusive behind-the-scenes content, early access, and connect with you on a more personal level. Please check the link in the description. Let's start the video now. After Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's departure, Princess Anne said she did not think a slimmed-down monarchy was a desirable idea. In an exclusive interview with Adriana Cerlnot last year, Princess Anne shared her reservations regarding plans to streamline the royal family. The conversation shed light on the monarch's perspective amidst ongoing discussions about a more compact royal cohort. The Princess Royal's apprehension was palpable as she hinted at recent changes within the monarchy. She seemed less enthusiastic about the notion, especially given her increasing royal responsibilities in recent times. The idea of reducing the number of working royals, Anne remarked, seemed more plausible when there were a few more people around to help make that a justified comment. While not explicitly naming them, her remarks allude to figures like Prince Harry and Meghan Markle, who stepped away from royal duties in 2020 and relocated to the United States. Additionally, Prince Andrew's departure from official duties due to scrutiny surrounding his association with Jeffrey Epstein further fueled the discussions. The passing of Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip also contributed to the dwindling number of working royals, despite their advanced age. The royal couple remained dedicated to their duties until the end. Furthermore, several other senior members of the royal family, such as the Duke of Kent and Duke of Gloucester, have had to reduce their engagements due to age-related constraints. During the interview, Princess Anne candidly expressed her skepticism about the benefits of a slimmed-down monarchy, stating, "It doesn't sound like a good idea from where I'm standing." She highlighted the importance of continuity and stability that the monarchy, along with the Constitution, provides, emphasizing its unique role in fostering long-term stability. When questioned about the relevance of the monarchy in modern times, Anne acknowledged the ongoing conversations but reiterated her belief in its enduring significance. She emphasized the monarch's ability to connect with communities and uphold values of service and understanding sentiments often overlooked in media portrayals. Reflecting on her role within the royal family, particularly in light of her older brother Charles's ascension to the throne, Anne emphasized the family's commitment to supporting the monarch's duties. She underscored their collective contribution to maintaining continuity and fostering a deep connection with the people they serve. Princess Anne's dedication to her royal duties is widely recognized, with her consistently ranking as one of the hardest working members of the royal family, undertaking numerous engagements each calendar year. As discussions about the future of the monarchy continue, Princess Anne's insight offers a valuable perspective on the challenges and responsibilities facing the royal family in navigating a rapidly evolving societal landscape. So what do you think about this news, guys? Write down in the comments what you think and let me know. Until then, guess we'll just have to wait and see if things turn out to be something after all. Also, if you never want to miss any of my sizzling royal updates like this, subscribe and press the bell icon. As simple as that. So until the next time, hasta la vista.